For saving and loading our Tilemaps, we rely on Unity's default behavior for converting the Tilebase we have here to something serialized to write into a file. This results in something like this line. The only reference saved is the instance ID. The thing is, Unity's instance IDs are always unique, but not meant to use in cases like this, because you cannot for sure say that they will not be changed. In all my tests, this never happened, so I thought we should be fine. But one of my viewers, thank you, developer Jake, informed me about the instance IDs getting changed in their project. Of course, that's bad. And of course, this breaks the whole loading part. So, I came up with a fix. I actually learned about Unity's AssetDatabase. Somewhere deep in the depths of Unity, there is a database for all the assets in the game. And they all have a GUID. And lucky us, there's also an API for this. You can download the updated save handler script with the link in the description, or just make changes on your own. Now, let's take a look at the updated code. It's just a few lines. Let's start at the top by importing the Unity Editor package. This is where we can access the asset database. We're going to save the GUID from the asset database as an additional attribute along the existing ones. So I added a public string for the GUID from the asset database and expanded the constructor of the class. So where is this GUID now coming from? Right where we created tileInfo class, we will query for that string. This beautiful shortly named method returns us a boolean if it found an asset, which belongs to the object we passed in. In our case, this is the tilebase we want to save. Along the boolean, we retrieve two out variables from the method. The local ID is not from interest now, but it needs to be here. And the GUID variable here is getting filled if the method returned true, and we can pass it to the constructor. If it is false, I will simply log an error and the value is not getting saved. After saving, your JSON file should look something like this. Every tile now has an additional entry with the GUID. Now let's load this data. We will still use the instance ID as a first try. I don't know if this is faster than querying the asset database, but I like that the serialization happens in the background where the asset database approach needs manual coding. We will check if the deserialized tilebase is null. If it is, we will check the asset database. At first, we query for the path based on the given GUID. With this path, we can then retrieve whatever object belongs to this path, which is in our case a tilebase. By saving the initial and the updated tilebase value into the same variable, we can use the same line of code for both cases and set the tilebase in our tilemap. If nothing has been found, I just log an error and continue with the entry. And if you load large amounts of tiles or continuously load chunks during gameplay, it might be better for your performance to keep a reference between the tilebases and the GUID. That just depends on your amount of tiles, and like I said, I don't know how fast or slow querying the asset database is. But a working solution might give you enough motivation to research deeper into this topic. Let me know in the comments if you know something interesting about this, or if it was your first time hearing of the asset database. At least for me it was. You can test the functionality of your script by simply changing the instance ID to something false. Then the logs of our asset database approach should appear. When changing the GUID as well, the error will be logged. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick and Naxwomo. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoyed the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.